I'll go on and I'll tell you, jump into my next mastermind, okay. And then I'll tell you how we went about doing this. Is, you know, I started studying marketing. I retired from music in 98, and I started studying marketing hard and heavy. Mm-hmm. I originally had another product I wanted to market online, and then I just was fascinated by internet marketing. I started reviewing products, but I wanted to go to the next level. And I was living in a little place outside of Austin called Wimberley, Texas. Mm-hmm. And my buddy Pat O'Brien was learning internet marketing. And so, Pat, let's do another mastermind. It worked well for us before.
Wow.
And then we found out, we were friends, we'd met Joe Vitale, he lived in our area. Yeah. Long story how Joe and I met.
Wow.
But we found, we didn't think, this is an important lesson for the last one. We'd never asked Joe to join the mastermind, because we assumed, well, Joe's, Joe's the 800-pound gorilla. In
sure.
The group. It's like, why would he want to join our group? But he did, and there's an important lesson. You might assume, well, why would someone like that want to come hang out with us? Well, you're doing the work of putting the group together, finding a place to meet, getting the other people. All they have to do is show up.
Yeah.
And internet marketing especially, because we work, you know, internet marketers, we work at home. Mm. We work in our home office. We don't get out much.
Right.
So Joe said, kind of, at least once a week, right, we had to get out of the house.
Oh, interesting.
So, shall I let you catch up?
Yeah, let me catch up. Bueno, muy interesante. Bill, después de toda esta experiencia, se pensó enfocarse más en marketing, en la ciencia de cómo vender, porque eso era el corazón de todas las cosas que estaba haciendo. Entonces, con su amigo Pat O'Brien, dijo, vamos a formar otro mastermind, porque tenemos tanto éxito con el primero, vamos a hacerlo de vuelta. Y hay otro muy famoso en internet marketing y también en marketing en general que se llama Joe Vitale. Y estaba en la misma ciudad y ellos se conocieron, eso es otra historia larga, pero nunca pensaron a preguntar a Joe Vitale para juntarse con ellos para este grupo, porque pensó, este es muy famoso, este es muy ocupado. Y entonces nunca lo preguntó, pero estoy seguro que algo pasó. Entonces, so you never asked Joe and it never occurred to you, but I'm sure the story is going in a good direction here.
Well, so what happened? We heard it through the grapevine, right. Actually through Joe's girlfriend. And mm-hmm. she had been in a mastermind with me at one point. Mm-hmm. And she said, Joe said if you would meet here in Wimberley instead of Austin, that he would join the group. So we ended up getting Craig Perlman. We had as many as 9 people at one point.
Okay.
And at the first meeting, what you do, and I want to back up in just a minute and tell you about how to form a group the right way.
Okay.
I don't think we did that. But at the first meeting, you go around the table and you say, what's your long-term goal? What are you here to do?
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, everybody stated what the, maybe it was an income goal, mm-hmm. or some project to be completed. And one thing I can say about that, is I'll never forget, is that when Joe was going down his long list of things, one of the things he said was that he says, oh, and by the way, this will sound crazy because I'm not an actor, but I want to be in a movie. And I want a speaking role. I don't want to be some guy standing at the bar.
Oh, wow.
So that he kind of threw that in. And then we continue to meet once a week, and about 2 or 3 months later, he says, you remember on the first meeting how I said I wanted to be in a movie? He says, I got an email today from someone on my list, this woman in Australia. She wants to put this movie together, but she doesn't have any money, and I'll probably never hear from her. But, you know, it came up. A few months later, you remember that woman I mentioned? Her name is Rhonda Byrne.
Rhonda Byrne.
And she's invited me to Chicago to come film this movie. And of course, you know, if you know Joe Vitale, you know I'm talking about The Secret.
Right, right. Let me catch him up. Bueno, me olvidé decir antes que Joe Vitale es el mismo persona que estaba en el movie, en la película El Secreto. Y lo que está diciendo Bill aquí es que no preguntaron a Joe si querían ser parte del conjunto porque creían que estaba muy ocupado, pero la novia de Joe dijo, mira, él tiene que salir de la casa un poco, está aburrido estar en casa, porque cuando trabajas en internet marketing estás en casa siempre. Entonces preguntaron a Joe y Joe dijo que sí y formaron el grupo. Y van a hablar más de cómo se forma el grupo, pero en el primer sitio que tiene el grupo, la primera vez que se juntan todos, cada uno tiene que decir por qué está aquí, qué son los objetivos que ellos tienen por el propósito, por qué se están juntando. Y Joe dijo, mira, yo no, yo escribo lo que sea, pero yo quiero estar en una película, yo quiero ser, yo quiero estar en una película famosa. Y esto es antes del secreto. Y entonces cuando estaba juntando el grupo, algunas semanas o meses después, dijo Joe, mira, no vas a creer esto, pero me llamó una mujer de Australia y dijo que quiere hacer una película, pero no tiene mucho dinero y no sé si voy a escuchar de ellos de vuelta. Y meses después, Ron DeBerne llamó, dijo, mira, tengo el dinero, vamos a juntarnos en Chicago. Y eso era el principio, eso como se formó la película El Secreto. Aquí está, en el mastermind de Bill.
That's a fabulous story. That's awesome. So
everybody, so even Joe, and everyone is at a best-selling book now. Everybody that's in the current group,
right?
All have publishing deals.
Wow.
From the mastermind.
Wow.
So, you know, I tell you these stories. I mean, they're fun stories.
Okay.
But these are the type of things that can happen.
Wow.
You get a mastermind, and we're talking about anytime you have one or more people coming together in a spirit of harmony with a common goal.
Let me capture that one.
Entonces, esto es una historia fabulosa. Todos los que estaban en ese grupo, en ese conjunto de Mastermind, todos, cada uno se hizo un autor con un libro, y este te voy a mostrar, pero yo tengo este libro en casa, Meet and Grow Rich. Cada uno tuvo un libro famoso, y dice que la ciencia de un Mastermind es cuando se junta un grupo en armonía, espiritualmente y mentalmente, esta cosa pasa. Es una cosa mágica del poder de no solamente una persona, pero juntarse en armonía con un grupo de personas.
Entonces, wow. So when you meet in the spirit of harmony and something happens, there's like a kind of a third person forms.
Another mind,
yeah.
Above the mind. You know, different people define it different ways.
Mm-hmm.
But everybody has felt it. And if you've ever, we've had it here where you and I might start talking about an idea and I say, wait a minute, but what if you did this? Oh wow! And then it just starts to go exponentially.
Wow!
And you can see this happen. I don't know, you can meet a mastermind once a week, once a month, and really feel it work. I mean, we could form an impromptu mastermind right now. We can grab a couple people
right
here and brainstorm. But in terms of somebody, I suggest that you have a regular group.
Okay.
And if you want to catch up, I'll tell you my advice for how to do that.
Okay. Bueno, lo que estamos hablando ahora es que cuando se junta un grupo así con un propósito, y la armonía, como estamos hablando, pasa una cosa muy interesante. Hay un mente arriba, y si hay tres personas, cuatro personas, una mente que se forma, que junta a toda la gente juntos. Y esa mente es una energía, es muy poderoso, y esa es la razón, que es muy poderoso para juntarse. Se puede hacerlo así rápido, puede juntar un grupo, pero es mucho más poderoso cuando se organiza bien y tienes una organización que se juntan.
So I was saying, you know, you could have an impromptu meeting like you said, but it's much more powerful when you get together with a purpose.
Formal mastermind.
Formal mastermind.
The ideal size for me of a group is 5 to 6 people.
Okay.
And any more people than that, and your meeting ends up going too long.
Yeah.
And any less people than that, you start getting people that can't make it 1 week because they're on vacation, and suddenly you've got 2 or 3 people. Well, it doesn't really work. So 5 to 6 is the ideal size. But I don't suggest just going out and grabbing 4 or 5 people.
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh, you.
Right.
Because remember the harmony.
Yeah.
And you can't always just randomly find people that are going to get along famously. I mean, you know, look at the divorce rate for just bringing 2 people together.
Yeah, sure.
So what I suggest you do is find 1 person. Start out with 1 person. Agree to meet for a few weeks. And if you have a spirit of harmony, if you're getting along, yeah, we like each other. Together, the 2 of you, go out and find a 3rd person. Bring that person in on a temporary basis. You first interview them.
Mm.
Now, if you want to avoid people that are really negative, you don't need that. We get for those of us trying to start our own business, we get plenty of negativity.
Sure. From the outside world, right.
We don't need it in our mastermind.
Right. Let me catch up to there.
Okay.
So está hablando de la ciencia de cómo formar un grupo y dice que una técnica muy interesante es porque si juntas muchas, dice que idealmente 5 a 6 personas es un grupo bueno. Que si tiene muchas más personas que eso, muchas veces hay mucha dificultad en juntarse todos juntos el mismo día.
pero dice, a lo mejor la mejor forma de hacerlo es pensar que una persona, dos personas se juntan y así se forma, a ver si está la armonía, si todo está, fluye bien.